Roush Fenway driver Greg Biffle visited the Florida Aquarium this week to swim with the aquatic wildlife and take in a backstage penguin encounter. Biffle's trip was part of the 2009 Coke Zero 400 Media Day in Tampa. The winner of the 2003 Midsummer Classic also previewed the upcoming 51st annual Coke Zero 400 powered by Coca-Cola on Saturday, July 4th with the Tampa-based media, participated in numerous radio interviews, and battled promotional winners and racing simulators at the nearby GameWorks Arcade in Ybor City. Biffle enjoyed his visit to the Florida Aquarium, which is home to more than 20,000 aquatic plants and animals representing species from Florida and around the world. Animals have always had a special place in Biffle's heart. Along with his wife, Nicole, Greg formed the Greg Biffle Foundation in 2005 to create awareness and serve as advocates to improve the well-being of animals by engaging the power and passion of the motorsports industry. During his penguin encounter, Biffle met Pebbles, and in his swim in the Florida Aquarium's coral reef tank, he had an encounter with Flip the Turtle, along with many other types of aquatic wildlife.
It's been a great day. I mean, I'm so excited. They call this work for me. You know, this is, I have to come to work and do these things, but this is really fun. I mean, to get to swim with these great creatures, all these animals, it's all these fish, it's pretty neat to get an opportunity to be able to do that. And I'm having a great day so far. I got to, you know, meet the little guy, and he wants to chew on the radio cord, do all that stuff, so it's pretty fun.
The Coke Zero 400 marks an important moment in Biffle's NASCAR career. Biffle, who has NASCAR Nationwide Series and Camping World Truck Series titles to his credit, captured his first career NASCAR Sprint Cup Series victory in the 2003 Independence Day Holiday Classic at Daytona International Speedway. Being able to break through with his first career Sprint Cup win at Daytona International Speedway was a dream scenario for Biffle.
I don't think I could have picked a better racetrack. You know, it was something spectacular for us to be able to win there in the old Granger car. But we'd sure like to get the 3 and 4 Fusion victory lane. We feel like we can. We've had great success there. Matt won the 500. Jamie won last year or a couple years ago there in July. So we keep, you know, chipping away at it. Maybe we can get together and win one.
A solid run for Biffle in July's 400-mile event would be helpful as he tries to make the chase for the Sprint Cup after a two-year absence. He's currently in the chase for the Sprint Cup and is looking forward to strapping into his 3M Ford and tackling the high banks of Daytona in the Independence Day Holiday Classic.
Really excited about that. That's one race that we got, you know, marked on our schedule is, come restrictor plate race in July under the lights in Daytona. That's pretty exciting stuff. You know, it's really neat to be able to do. And it's a great opportunity for us to get down there and restrictor plate race. Where else would you want to be other than July in Daytona under the lights?
Tickets for the 51st annual Coke Zero 400 powered by Coca-Cola on Saturday, July 4th start at $40 and can be purchased online at www.daytonainternationalspeedway.com or by calling 1-800-PITCHSHOP.